Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to FTB Genesis. My name is Whisperfire, and I think I need a friend. Yeah, but basically, I need to do some trading, but we don't have villagers. I'm going to have to trade with piglins. And this is why. I've been looking through the quest progression. So, first place I looked at was under Project Genesis. We made it under Resources Get, and then this branches out. So, thinking about getting this little thing over here, which says we work in biotechnology, and then work into engineered creation. But in order to work in biotechnology, we can progress through the Botania questline up until this point, because the terrestrial agglomeration plate requires a rune of mana. In order to get a rune of mana, we need to get something called a solar prism from Elemental Craft. So we have to dive into another mod. So, looked under Primal Forces. Look through the whole thing, and the solar prism is way down here. We have to go far into Elemental Craft. So, the simple goal of setting up an infrastructure in Botania. Well, I don't think we'll be able to complete it today, but we'll be able to make some dang good progress. And for the Elemental Craft, we need to eventually make something called a white rock, which requires gilded blackstone. Well, I searched the nether and found no structures that had the gilded blackstone. I found a biome full of blackstone, but no structure. So I had to ask the Discord, and they said trade or go through Cyclic, because Cyclic has this machine. Let me see if I can call it up. So through Cyclic, we could use a solidification chamber, but it requires obsidian pressure plates. At this time, I have no way of mining obsidian. We don't have access to diamonds. And I think that requires a pneumatic craft. So for now, let's I think this will do it. Let's grab some gold ingots. We're gonna do some trading. Yeah. So we're going into the nether. Now, I'm going to show you where I found the blackstone. If you hit map, there's a whole section right down here. So, to help out, I built a bridge. I built a simple bridge, something that will protect me from ghast fire. And yes, I did die once while constructing it, but I think it was well worth it. Because we could just go over here, and then up this hill, and voila, we got all the blackstone that we... Well, what the heck? What is that? What is... Okay. Enough talking. Let's get out of here. Okay. I need to patch up those lava pools because, yeah, that kind of freaked me out. I don't know what that is. I don't want to know. Okay. Let's fill up on the water. I will stop yapping, and we will start trading. So, hopefully, I can just stay right here. No? Need a piglin. I hear them. You're zombified. Okay. Zombie piglins have no interest in gold. It's the regular piglins that we're looking for. Come on. Okay. Got one. All right, let's start trading. This is going to be interesting. Maybe if I put these in advance, you'll just start giving me... Oh, he died. Did I have thorns on this thing? Well, we got glowstone essence and blaze essence. Okay. Let's see if we can find another contestant. Let's see. These look like zombies. There's someone glowing blue. Ow. Maybe. Maybe he's stuck? No. He's some kind of epic creature. Okay, let me see if I can find someone. Ooh. See if we could do some trading. Yeah, without a trading station, this is going to be a little bit more challenging. Thankfully, this armor is pretty good. That makes me nervous. I don't like those things. Excuse me, pardon me, coming through. Oh. Don't notice me. Don't look here. Okay. As long as we keep them distracted, we could do this. Oh, yes. Gilded Blackstone. They are very quick to turn on you. Pothic affixes. Alright, we got two piglins. Okay, one of them wandered off. Where are you going? I take it they don't like the zombified Pikmin? This guy really wants to hit me. Damn it. Where's that other guy? Okay, I am out of inventory space. Let's head on home and see what we got. So, we got actually ancient debris, crying obsidian, two sets of rubber boots enchanted, some withered skull caps, but mostly I wanted the gilded black stone. So, let's grab a barrel and let's put this away and we'll get started with the Botania part, though. Yep, I'll figure it out. But we got obsidian essence, and if we hit uses, we can get the obsidian and we could actually get the solidification chamber. So this is an alternative way of getting obsidian. Come back here. And yeah, I'll meet you at the Botania section. So if you recall, this is our current Botania setup. We used the custom modded Energizer flower from Botanic Editions so that we have the fluid tank into the combustion chamber, to the battery box, into this. And we got less than half of a mana pool. So that's 405k units of mana. What I did inside the farmland was I laid down some dirt blocks to turn into grass blocks. And I basically started producing living rock and living wood logs. So let's do some reading. Let's go into Botania. And I think we're going to start with the mana infused metal. By refining iron and then infusing it with this living energy, it takes on a brilliant blue hue and resonates with the flow of that energy. It seems to self-heal whenever it's near mana. This may be useful to make tools out of. So we need 3 mana-infused ingots. So, I got some refined ingots. Also, I'm going to get a block of iron. Now, I don't know if this is the case, but according to JEI, you see this ordinary block of iron? I think we could use that to make a block of mana steel without having to refine it like this. Okay. So, I think we need to submit it. We get the Mana Steel Pickaxe and the Enchanted Book Efficiency 3. That's nice. Very nice. Okay, the last thing on this branch, the Catalytic Converter. This catalyst redirects the infusion of the energy from an internal to an external effect. Items brought into contact with this excited state of energy transform into entirely different items. So, we need some contained crystals. This is from Elemental Craft. So, we got this. Oops. And we got two brewing stands. Let's start with that. Okay. Go ahead and put these in here. Grab this. Grab that. Grab that. Grab this and that. Alright, crafting table. So, we're gonna need two of these. Okay, grab that. We're gonna need a mana lens. So we're gonna need four more mana steel. Okay, let's go ahead and dump the whole thing in. Right, so we got a mana lens. Two brewing stands. Okay, we got that. All right. And a contained crystal. All right. So we need some living rock. There we go. An alchemy catalyst. What I'm going to do, I'm going to open this and open this. I don't think we need it for now, so I'm going to put it here for storage. So if I ever need the alchemy catalyst, we could break it and move it underneath the mana pool. Cool? Cool. Let's claim our rewards, which is a warp lens, a force relay. What the heck's that? Two levels of experience. Okay. Next, a flower's best friend. Mana diamonds are able to concentrate a large amount of mana inside their crystalline structure. Diamonds are a rare commodity, but thanks to the discovery of the dimensional shard's trans-dimensional resonance, we've adapted the process to use them as well. So, I'm going to put this here. And we got ourselves a mana diamond coming right up with the dimensional shard. And next. Claim this, claim that. Let's put this in here. And let's hit our quest. Portable containment. This portable mana tablet allows the user of mana to repair tools and power curios on the go. Okay, so, mana tablet. Okay, portable containment, check. We've got a floating white flower. Okay, I will put that in there. That and that for now. Next. Yes, we are bumping right through this. Runic altar. The runic altar can have mana directed towards it to infuse multiple items and embed them into a living rock apparatus. These forged rooms have altered metaphysical properties based on the material combinations and can theoretically be used to create many useful devices that are powered by this energy. Okay, what do we need for a runic altar? Okay, wham bam, thank you, ma'am. Let's put that here. Right. And we got our wands. Actually, better yet. What do we need to make a mana spreader? Oops, I hit the caps lock. Okay, we need more of that weird, funky glass. It looks like they don't have it, or I seem to have misplaced it. Oh well, we'll figure out something. Okay, next. Botanical Brewery. Thank you, I like that. Botanical Brewery? I can put you right here. There we go. I love using the Botanical Brewery, by the way. Okay. Runic. We need to make runes of water, earth, air, and fire. And let's read what it says. Different types of materials yield different runic properties. You'll need several different ones to continue the research in this field. Okay. Here are all of our supplies right here. Okay. Put you here. And let's start crafting. Let's start with water. We need mana powder. Okay. Mana powder. And 4 mana ingots. Okay. And let's see. Fishing rod, mana powder, mana steel. Fishing rod, mana powder, mana steel. Bone meal, sugarcane. Okay. One of this, one of that. Now, take the mana spreader, shift right click onto that. And okay, it's coming back to me. All right, next. Rune of Earth. Mushroom, coal, stone. Mushroom, coal, stone. Okay. Coal, mana, mana, mushroom. Okay. Gonna need another. Okay, we are doing good. Next on the list, Rune of Air. String carpet. Well, we got string from the nether simulation. String. Okay, come on. Wabam. Last. Rune of Fire. Gunpowder, which I got from a trade. Nether brick, nether wart. Okay. Living rock. All right, now let's shift, right click, put this back in the mana pool. We got our runes. Now, let's take a look at this. Got another blacker lotus, a floating exoflame, and a leather. Okay, the floating exoflame. I'm gonna put you here. And right click onto that. Okay. Blacker lotus. And how much mana do we have? Okay, we used quite a bit. We used up about 100k units. That's fine. Rune of mana. We would need 5 mana steel, 1 solar prism. We can't do that. But the energy agglomeration pad, in order to make this, we need that rune of mana. So for now, let's grab 2, 3, 4. Let's set up a place for our pad. So right here, just knock this out. Just so that we have a spot reserved for our trans-agglomeration pad. I think it's like this. At least I think. I'm going to need Lexica Botania to double check. Give me a second. Roshic Tome. Lexica Botania. Mm-hmm. Let's see if we can find this. Is there a search option? There's Living Rock under the plate. That's what I wanted to know. Let's go ahead and turn off the visualization. Okay, so at this point, we have done everything we could. We can make sparks, but I don't think there's really any need for it. And I got some floral fertilizer and some bone meal. I was planning, check this out. I went ahead and put dirt blocks here so that we could grow our own flowers. Like that. That did not yield much. Let's see, can we get more? Okay, 2 more. Got some blue, some purple. 1 more. Black. Very, very unlucky. We're gonna have to make do and hope that there's more quest rewards where we could, where we could get more floral fertilizer or unlock the craft through elemental craft. Right. Yeah, I'll keep that one on me. Keep this. The flowers I will put here. Just for safekeeping. Next, we need to do elemental craft. So let's go ahead and claim all of our rewards. Let's see. Put you here. Put you here. I guess I'll keep that there. So, yeah. Okay. Cleared inventory. Here we go. Wow. Gone bananas. All right. Take a look at what we got. We got extra facial storage cells. I think I was tinkering with something. Copper ingots, fishing nets, fluid tanks. Okay, emu. Who would eat emu? Ew. Okay, that's apotheosis. Apotheosis. That's definitely mechanism. Well, it looks like we got some noms and some pneumatic crap. Okay. Dip. Up in the air. No, it's left click. There. Is there a book for elemental craft? Well, we got mystical agriculture. Here we go. Elemental craft. Basics, inert crystal, contain crystal, and shards. That's all we've unlocked. Let me grab some materials and get set up. Well, time flies when you're being productive and overall having fun. We are out of time for today, but I'm getting started with elemental craft. You see this container of oil with me? Well, what I plan to do is take the Amadron tablet And if you go down to the very bottom, I think I need to do that and that. Okay. Now, you see that there's a trade for 5 buckets for an inert crystal? Well, if you go down to the bottom, there's a second trade, 4 buckets with an inert crystal. So, I'm going to plan to go around to various oil deposits and collect as much as I can and basically farm up on inert crystals. Yep. I'm going to sit here and watch them do the Amadron trade. Put that there. Give it a moment. Let that reappear. And we can get all of our inert crystals. I get the feeling that we're going to need a lot of them. So, I'm going to wrap it up here, but next episode, we are going to go into the primal forces. Yeah, going into the primal forces, that includes going out to these locations and getting various sources of elemental energy, and eventually get the solar prism so we can get back to Botania. But there's one more loose end that I want to figure out. Okay, when we unlocked or got all of our rewards, there was something in biotechnology. Nope, in selected breeding. Enhanced farming, optional. And it said, "You are a skilled botanist indeed to recognize my masterful work. I trust you will care and provide for the plants herein, and I hereby grant you full access to my private labs. It's the soil you see. Subsoils and ideal conditions seem to make the plants grow so much better. To that end, I've created a superior version of my original farming simulation, and now I place it in your capable hands. Good luck." So, let's go ahead and take care of this loose end because I am flat out curious what this superior farming simulation is. So, I went ahead and shut down the farming simulation that was running. Let's activate the simulation. Structure has been materialized. Structure is safe to be stored on spatial disk. So we got a blank spatial cell. I'm gonna put it there. And I'm gonna rename it. I think I'm gonna name it lab, but botanical lab. All right, let's check this out. Okay, a lot of... Oh. I like this. Much more efficient with space. And uranium blocks, thermoelectric generator. We could actually generate power. LV flux converter. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. We got journals to read. Oh, wow. I'm just amazed. Netherite trap door. More farming. Okay, I am impressed. This is superior. I will definitely have to move my farming activities to here. But I hear something. Dark connected glass for darkened, okay. With an airlock and everything. Holy crap. Yeah, this seems impressive. Definitely planning to move all of my farming stuff to here. My goodness, this is great. Don't know what I'm going to do with all this, but we got our own power generation. Yeah, this is just Awesome. Okay. Definitely going to wrap it up here. I think there was a journal and the other farming simulation. I'll dig it up. And we could actually read through both journals when we're back to going into agriculture. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and say goodbye. So be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah.